When and will my hair transplant thicken and blend with the non-transplanted hair? Hello, I had a follicular unit extraction in December 2012. 1,500 grafts were placed in the front of my head. My hair started growing at 4 months and seems to continue to grow slowly. The growth is sparse and not even. I'm going into the 10th month now. My transplanted hair does not match the non-transplanted. In fact, it has blotchy, thin areas that look like holes. Should I hang in there a bit longer? Should I contact the medical doctor who performed the surgery? Should I be worried? Any help is appreciated. Thanks, Joe.
Thank you, Joe, for your question. You had a transplant and you're at the 10-month point where you feel that your hair appearance is blotchy and you're concerned. And one of the questions you asked is about contacting your MD. Well, you should definitely contact your MD. My philosophy, and I perform a lot of hair transplants, and in my practice, I have had a remarkable opportunity to be in a leadership position in a what I feel is a great emerging field of hair regeneration. And I'm going to discuss this momentarily. Having a continuous dialogue and communication is paramount to any surgery. And hair restoration surgery has a lot of challenges that you need to be aware of, and I'm assuming you were aware of when you had your procedure. So let's understand what the purpose of hair transplant surgery is. Male pattern hair loss, which is basically 95% of what most men experience in terms of hair loss, has a progression. Now that progression, it can be fast, it can be slow, and a hair transplant is the strategic placement of genetically resistant hairs to help fill areas that are affected by male pattern hair loss. Now this has to be in the context of the progression and the future of where a person's male pattern hair loss will be after their transplant. You see, the genetically resistant area, known as the donor area, it's not likely to fall out. However, with a hair transplant, not every graft that's placed will take. In our practice, we use extracellular matrix made by a company called Acell, and it is part of the way we do our transplantation so that we can maximize the yield and the healing of both the donor area and the hair grafts. Now, I do this also in the context of strategy of progression. So for us, what we generally do is if someone is at a point where they may not need a transplant because they've got a lot of thinning that we can address by using our hair regeneration system. And our hair regeneration system, to give you some more detail, we've been able to actually use extracellular matrix with platelet-rich plasma. And I have a lot of experience as a cosmetic and reconstructive surgeon in the application of extracellular matrix for wound healing, for cosmetic and reconstructive procedures. And I've applied this to a method and technique of helping men and women with hair thinning. And what we appear to be doing is restoring the critical stem cells through a limited and specific wound healing mechanism that causes thinning hair to become thicker. So, what I believe you're in a stage of is where some of the hairs are coming in, some of your existing hairs may have dropped out from shock loss, even though that's early typically, but hair grows in cycles, and there is three specific phases: anagen, catagen, and telogen. Now, the anagen phase is the growth phase. And when a hair transplant is taking, there are going to be various hairs in the different anagen phases. Initially, there can be shock loss affecting both the existing hair as well as the grafted hair. So in our practice, we wait. We see people regularly, but we wait for a year or beyond a year to then make some kind of conclusion as to the benefit of the hair transplant surgery that we've performed. And generally, it is understood that people may need more than one transplant session to get the results that they desire. There's a lot of factors in determining the effectiveness of a transplant, but the limiting factor is the density and available hairs in your donor area. So whether you do a strip method or FUE method, you only have so many hairs to transplant. And that's why in our practice, we are extremely excited to help people, especially younger people, or people who are starting to thin, by regenerating their existing hair, so that even if we need to do a transplant, we can be so much more strategic about the transplantation. So my advice to you is to communicate with your doctor, review with your doctor your preoperative photos and what the strategy was, where you had the grafts placed, and what your expectations are to be reasonably moving forward. I think that at the year to year and a half point, you'll be able to make a clear conclusion as to how much of the grafts actually took, and then what you should do in order to get the look that you want. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.